Hello. Last time we discussed getting close to the instrument on a personal level, doing what comes natural and pleasant, and the fact that as you spend time with your instrument, a personal representation starts to form within your perception on how different notes make you feel, how you hear each sound individually. This way, you can start to predict how the guitar will sound as you play it. This is a process that takes time. If you experiment by playing each possible note on each string, your mind will, on some level, already know how each place sounds like, but it takes time for that level to reach the surface, so the notes you play won't come as a surprise to you. You will perceive them somehow by their sound, concrete or abstract shapes in space, colors, feelings, and so on. This is what I mean by each note on each string. Lesson, we will talk about three things: air guitar, vocabulary, and movement while playing. Air guitar is very important because it indicates the feeling in your body, the relaxation that you want when approaching your instrument. You want to feel as natural playing your instrument as you do when you are doing air guitar. Even if maybe you'll have deeper feelings of connection while actually playing. There is a way of playing your instrument that is very similar to air guitar, without specific combinations of notes, but just letting your hands fly on the strings. Try doing air guitar while holding your guitar, without actually touching the strings. See what your hands want to do. Then, little by little, bring your hands close to the strings until you're actually touching the strings. Then, press harder within your comfort level. This will feel very natural, and you will start developing a sense of where your hands want to go on your instrument. It's very important to have this kind of intuition, like staring at a blank piece of paper with a brush in your hand. And feeling where the brush needs to go. It has to feel right. If the movement doesn't come, just wait until it does. Don't rush it. Try to limit your movement to what feels right, desirable, necessary, appropriate, or whatever feeling you would like to elicit at that moment. I'll say that again. Try to limit your movement to what feels right, desirable, necessary, appropriate, or whatever feeling you would like to elicit at that moment. Maybe you want to experiment doing the things that feel wrong or uncomfortable. That's also great. Try everything you can think of. Now experiment by slowing things down. Or speeding them up. Try many speeds so you see how they feel and what kinds of sounds they produce. This is a mode of playing your instrument. Next, another way of playing is by constructing combinations of notes like syntax or speaking in sentences. You already have a set of many elements, they're the single notes that you can play. Then there are combinations of two or three notes. Try different techniques. Hammer on. That means when you pluck a string, the hammer-on, when you pluck a string and while it is playing, you hammer the same string on another fret, another space, with one of the other fingers, like this. Another technique is the pull-off, which is similar to the hammer-on, except you pluck a string with your finger. You touch the same string with another finger, you press on it, and then you release the first finger. You may want to induce a downward motion to the first finger, the one you plucked the first time, so that it itself plucks the string. Another technique is the slide. When you pluck a string and then you move the finger while still pressing. The vibrato, when you keep pressing the finger and then you move it back and forth or up and down. Another element is comprised of two or three notes at the same time on different strings. This takes time and a little practice to get right. Another element, smaller or larger intervals between notes. Arpeggios. You can even skip a string. Harmonics, we talked about this in the first lesson a little bit. Don't forget about open strings. You can try playing with little spaces of silence between these elements, so they sound separate to you. All of a sudden, a vocabulary starts taking shape. In time, you can start building more complex combinations or try to play them as a single line, only adding silence at the end. Now silence. And again. Again silence. And again. If structure is what you're after in your playing, structure will emerge naturally from doing random combinations. You'll begin to have preferences, or a better way of putting it is that different elements will represent different things for you. A very good tool to play with is having a control group for your playing from a rhythmical point of view. That sounds a bit technical, a control group for your rhythm, but I find it a very useful and fun tool. What that is moving a certain part of your body to your music, or more than one part of your body. I'm sure you've seen guitar players that move their feet, or head, or mouth to the music that they play. Experiment with different parts of your body and different types of movement, depending on how you feel at the moment, what sparks your interest, and what part of your body wants to move. Maybe it's your eyes. Your breath. Your eyebrows. Use your imagination. Maybe it's your brain. Maybe you want to picture something or think about something in particular. Try many different things while doing the air guitar mode. Or the syntactic mode, you'll see that all of them feel different. Try mixing them up, doing one of them until you find that another wants to come to life. Then maybe you want to take a break. Try keeping the guitar in playing position while taking a break. Maybe you'll find that you start playing without realizing it. I'd be very interested in hearing what you play when you don't realize you're playing. Have fun!